Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
No, let everything be here. You can start. Because there are other things. Okay. This is for the prayers. This plate is for the prayers. Okay. Hare Krishna. Thank you, Namkirti. This is the last, almost the last presentation of the whole retreat, and I know everybody must be exhausted because lack of sleep, and the top is pretty heavy. Like, you know, it makes you go in internally and contemplate, like, wow, you know, I have all this stuff to work on. So in one sense, it's nice that we are doing the interactive session in the end. So it's an opportunity actually to absorb whatever you have heard. I'll be very honest. This is my first public speaking presentation. I've never done that. I'm more comfortable with one-on-one. And it's interesting. I've been given an hour and a half to do this, so it's challenging in that sense. And my biggest support and inspiration, Sri Rupa, who usually supports me, like I needed Kirtan and she's usually there, but somehow Krishna's arrangement, she lost her voice. So I was super nervous. Oh, now what am I going to do? My star presenter, Sri Rupa, doesn't have her. But Krishna's arrangement, Namkirti, even though it was the last minute, she agreed to do, and she's nervous. We both are nervous. But I said, it's okay. It's okay to be nervous because we both attended a weekend seminar last weekend. One of our god sister, Mother Krishna Leela, did. And she mainly helped us deal with shame. So we both are practicing that right now in action. So I'm sure Mataji is going to be very happy with us. Like, you know, we are putting in action what we learned. So don't get your expectations, like, you know, keep it very realistic. I have a humble request. Though it is interactive, I would really like everybody to be really present. You know, wherever your mind is and wherever your body is, try to come into this room and participate, like, full-heartedly, like, you know, with your mind and your soul, and body. Because it's a collective thing when you do something like this, because there's conversations happening and it's very easy to drift. So if we all stay together in a very meditative mood and be conscious of that, I think we'll get most out of it. Yes. Oh, that's fine. If you have children and they're not really making noise and, like, you know, they're whispering and talking, I'm fine. But if it's like if they're going to be really loud and they're disturbing, then please take them downstairs. And you can always get up and go. I know you're taking care of your two little boys this weekend. Of course, you can go and come in. No problem. I would like all of you to group into like five, like, you know, groups of five. And I would prefer it's like a semicircle. Like, you know, maybe you four can be a group because you're doing service together. And Prahlad, I would like you to be my assistant too when I call you. So if you can form your groups. Okay. Is there a way we can move these pews little bit in an angle, Prabhu? I think that group is too far. Yeah. Nini, is there a way we can get this group closer with chairs and all?
Okay, bye guys, I'm too sure.
Maybe from the lobby, I'll get. From the office too, Shamsaki? From the office you can get. Shamsaki knows. Like, okay, you can get.
Should I get some chairs?
Yeah, you see how many chairs they need. Oh, hey, Vaishnavata. Okay.
I'm making her sing with me. Do you need the words?
No, let's go.
Ready?
Oi Vaishnava Thakura Dayara Sakara Eta Se Karuna Kori. Chaya Shodhaniya Maya Tomara Charana Dori Diya Pada Chaya Shodhaniya Maya Tomara Charana Dori Chaya Dega Domi Chaya Dosha Shodhi Chaya guna deho tase Chaya vega domi Chaya dosha shodhi Chaya guna deho tase Chaya sata sangha Deho he amara Kusichi sangye rashe Suchi Sangha Rashi
Vigati Amara
Kahi Paya Bala Hari Nama Sankirtane
Vigati Amara
Krishna Namadane
Bhakti
Shada Bindu Diya Deho Krishna Namadane Krishna Se Tumara Krishna Dite Paro Tumara Shakati Ache Tumara Krishna Dite Paro Tumara Shakati Ache Ami To Tumara Krishna Krishna Bari Tai Tava Pache Pache Vaishnav Thakur Jaya Vaishnav Thakur That was beautiful Naam Kirti. And thank you so much, you know. You know, somebody who is very shy to sing and to put that in her lap in the last minute and taking the courage to do it, thank you so much. It's giving me a lot of strength and inspiration. Thank you. Actually, this presentation was supposed to be done by Rajiv Khattar. And he's expert at this. And Maharaj was just like glorifying like how good he is and how well his presentation is received. So, but 2 weeks back, he realized that he has to travel today on work. So Maharaj asked him to like help me, coach like how the presentations are done. So he did that. And actually this topic is Rajiv's topic. I didn't come up with this topic, facing your addiction. So if you like the title and if you like the presentation, maybe part of the credit goes to Rajiv. And of course, my husband, Nityananda Pran Prabhu, and my greatest friend and guide in Krishna consciousness, Mother Krishna Leela, they coached me. Because I was very nervous to do this, and they helped me put the presentation together, and it sounded very exciting. And yesterday I shared with some of my girlfriends, you know, because I was really nervous, and I said, we went upstairs and I said, I'm doing this. They said, yes. So thank you all, like, you know, they said, Mataji, you can do it. So I'm very grateful for that, because I'm grateful to Maharaj. Actually, this is the first thing I'm doing. Like yesterday was a big announcement. I never thought in my life I'll be a temple president, but now I'm a temple president. I never thought I'll be a public speaker. Today I'm going to present something. So it's a little overwhelming. So when you look at this picture, what comes to your mind? Raise your hands. Okay.
You want someone to run the mic?
Yeah, that would be nice. Marcel can do that. Yeah, I would like them to speak, sir.
I'll go first. This man's about to be crushed.
Okay.
Put a couple more of those, whatever those are, and it's my life.
Okay, we have one here.
The end. He's thinking how to get into that bar.
Oh, how to get into that. Okay. Marcel, can
he looks confused, like thoroughly confused.
Okay, after Sanya, Krishna Prema Prabhu.
It shows your insignificance.
Okay. Krishna Prema Prabhu, you have to raise your hand.
Looks like he lost his way and thinking how to get back.
Huh?
He lost his way.
Okay. Rahul Prabhu. Two more and then.
It seems that it's a big ship that he must have seen a long time ago. Probably as he goes close to it, he is looking if there is some person on there who could help him.
Ah, okay. Interesting. Who? There were two hands here. Okay. Okay.
I think he's feeling overwhelmed and kind of helpless.
He's trying to explore more.
Explore more. Okay. Okay. Here, and this will be our last.
He finally found the land.
Okay, finally found the land. Wow. Yeah.
First I said this man's about to be crushed, but Yamuna Jivan and I were talking. It seems like perhaps there's hope.
Oh, there's hope.
A small boat and seems to be lost at sea, now there's hope.
Yeah. Mm. It's interesting how different individuals, according to the perceptions they carry about life and how they look at a picture, and each and every, you know, answer is in one sense right. There's nothing right or wrong. When I looked at this picture, for me the big ship seemed like my anarthas, and I'm like, it's a ship, it's a huge ship, and I was thinking, this is me, my life, this boat, this life, and I'm overwhelmed, my God, like what should I do? So it's interesting. So addictions, even though I'm giving the name addictions, in one sense, it is, we're talking about anarthas, because addictions are also anarthas, because nobody likes their addictions, just like we don't like our anarthas. So what is an addiction? Yeah, that I would like you to discuss in your group for about 2 or 3 minutes. And you can choose, there will be a lot of this thing, please choose your spokesperson from your group. So maybe you can discuss about, like, we have a lot to cover, so we'll stick to time. So 2 to 3 minutes. Your 2 minutes are up. Which group is ready with a definition? Children, if you're going to be in the room, you have to be quiet. Thank you. Okay. Yes. We go, since they're the one first to start, we'll go like this. Yes, go ahead, Prabhu. Can you give me your name, please?
My name is Brad.
Brad? Okay, sharing is starting. Yes.
So addiction would be something that you derive pleasure from, but that you know that's going to bring you pain, but you can't stop doing it.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, you get something from it, obviously, or you would not do it.
Mm-hmm.
And you know that you're going to feel bad, that it's bad for you ultimately, but you continue to do it.
Thank you. Madhumangal Prabhu, your group. Oh, I messed up. Nick, go ahead. Oh, he's a speaker for your group? Okay, why don't we do Rahul Prabhu's group?
We were just debating addiction now. We have two, I mean, the addiction could be sometimes negative or positive.
Great, uh-huh.
So, negative could be detrimental to the individual, but not knowing, but unable to detach from that.
Okay.
There could be a good addiction, but doing mechanically without feelings. But at the end of the day, you won't get much results.
Good. Thank you. Rahul Prabhu, your group.
So, addiction is something are under compulsion doing it.
Mm-hmm.
And the more we do it, the more we get sucked into it.
Mm-hmm.
And there could be a positive meaning or context to the term, but we are using it only in negative context because usually we don't get addicted to good things.
Hmm.
So, for example, Prabhu gave a very good example of, we don't get addicted to chanting, for example.
Hmm.
But, so usually addiction is towards more bad things.
Okay.
As Prabhu pointed out that, we know that it is bad for us, but we still do it.
Okay. Thank you. Vamsithari Prabhu.
So that is something people are starting with when they to cope up some stress like that, and then end up not able to overcome it, and sometimes it seems difficult to overcome it.
Yes.
And so the reason for they finding hope in that activity, and the practice will be become sometimes conscious or unconscious.
Hmm.
They keep doing it.
Yes. Thank you so much.
We define an addiction
closer
as an obsession that you can't refrain from and you can't rationalize yourself out of it.
Wow. Pretty succinct. They're done. Mansinganga Mataji School.
We said multiple things, but something that one knows that one should do but not able to refrain. But the other additions are, for some of us it felt like Maharaj's presentation on Hriday Daurbalyam.
Hmm.
And then something also is, if it's not checked, then one never feels satisfied, it's always increasing.
Mm-hmm.
Can be positive or negative.
Yes.
And but at the same time, it is something that one can overcome. It's not like there's no way out of it.
Good, good. Krishnashna Mataji's group here.
We considered if addiction was a term that could be used for something like reading books. Move the discussion to understanding that actually addiction has a pejorative
mm-hmm.
connotation. So we understood it as a habit that isn't necessarily beneficial, or a habit that doesn't bring relief.
Mm-hmm.
And also there's an unstoppable component that, and a person is generally controlled by an addiction. There's an inability to actually give up the particular behavior that makes up that habit or activity.
Thank you. Shamsaki? Shweta, can you read that loud and clear? Yeah. Okay.
Addiction is characterized by inability to consistently abstain, impairment in behavioral control, craving, diminished recognition of significant problems with one's behavior and interpersonal relationships, and a dysfunctional emotional response. Like other chronic diseases, addiction often involves cycles of relapse and remission.
Hmm. So this is the dictionary definition of addiction. So like some of you mentioned, there's some addictions which are like socially frowned upon. Ira, you can join a group. Yeah, just join a group. So addictions, there are some addictions which are socially frowned upon, like taking drugs, being alcoholic, addicted to sex. So it's something very, something that we all like know very clearly is this, it's not acceptable in the society. But actually, like I think Krishna Prema's group and I think even Mansi Ganga Mata Satarupa's group mentioned that, but there are some addictions which like, you know, we don't even realize they're addiction because they're in mode of goodness. Like there, do you know people who are so particular about cleanliness? Like to the extent that, like cleanliness, what else is there? Cleanliness and what else? Something that, you know, it's a nice behavioral trait to have or characteristic to have. Workaholics. And, yes? Loud.
Reading.
I think even this group.
Being punctual.
Being punctual. Great, yes.
Karmakanda sacrifices,
yes. Surfing the internet or your phone? Okay. Yes. How you know, and mostly these ones which we think are actually like, you know, good behavioral trait or, you know, characteristics, it's very difficult to understand how these can be addictions because, you know, you're appreciated for that, you're rewarded for that. It's actually easy to recognize the ones, actually those socially that are unacceptable ones. So the way you can know that it's an addiction is when it's affecting the people you live with, the people you work with, when it's affecting your relationships. When it is affecting, like whether, you know, somebody who is like, you know, if somebody is very particular about being punctual, and if their spouse or their friends or their children can't be punctual, and if it is like, it really makes you lose your mind and you lose your sanity, you know that it's an addiction. It's no longer a gift of Krishna that, you know, I should be proud about. It is not. It is definitely, because it is detrimental. When it's detrimental to your relationship and your life, you know it's an addiction. You have something to say? Yes, they could be. But it's easy. When somebody's late all the time. Yes. But that's easy, you know. But it's easy because you lack something, so it's easy to recognize. But it's difficult to recognize when, you know, somebody has like a good quality and you think, oh, I'm right, you're wrong. Yes.
So are you saying that in priority position, our value system, so basically what you just said, the value system of any person should be, the relationship comes first before any other values, like being punctual or drinking or something like that?
It's a balance. You know, you have to have a balanced approach to this because sometimes some person may be having difficulty in being clean and they're extremely shabby and dirty. So that's a different anartha that they're suffering from. But especially if you keep getting a feedback from different relationships, like not just from your wife or just your boss, but your children, your father, mother, like, you know, if you're getting a common message that, hey, you know, this is really too much, you should understand it's an addiction. But sometimes, if, for instance, you know, between any relationship that's very close, like especially parents and children, you know, parents are, you know, they want to teach the children, being clean, and, you know, nothing much may happen with the children for some time, you know, they don't care. I don't see that's abnormal, you know. But if it's after a point where like almost the child is emotionally getting disturbed when the parent is being like too rigid about rules and regulation, how it's a very fine line. So you have to, fortunately we are devotees, so we have a devotee either as a mentor or a spiritual master or a counselor. Go and talk to them. Is this an addiction? Because these things are, it's very difficult to give a general answer, like, you know, because it's very subjective to identify if it's an addiction or it's a quality it's nice to be happy about. So it's better to go to somebody who knows you very well and who is in a capacity who can help you and ask them.
The question was about value system. So if our value system is meant to strengthen our relationships, But if those values are hurting our relationships, then we need to relook at our value system and how we are living them.
It's true, but sometimes they may not be...
The relationships that I have should be in highest value to me beyond motive goodness values.
So, and basically, so we go to the next point that I want to bring to our discussion is addictions are like, you know, they are means of survival. Pause for a minute and think. The anarthas or the addictions that we have. So they are like, you know, if you actually carefully contemplate, we get used to a particular thing, a habit, or conceptions that we have. We develop that through because of certain experiences we have in our life, and we have to survive through the circumstances, through the situations. And then we get addicted because it helps us to move forward and to somehow breathe oxygen. And sometimes it's, it's same, attachment or addiction, yeah. So now we can, like, you know, we go back, what you can do, you were given a piece of paper, right? Yes.
The discussion a little bit earlier on was looking at a particular behavior that has a positive connotation, like punctuality. So it brought to mind, are there some behaviors that would fall into the category of being obsessive versus being addictive?
Thank you. Good point. So you have a piece of paper, or you already wrote, Goloka Prabhu, you may have, those were for personal use actually. That's your thing. Did you give each one of you, do you have two sheets of paper that Goloka Prabhu gave? Okay, so then each one of you take two. Each participant needs to have two sheets of paper. Please write one on it, number one. Just write one, on it, number one. Everybody has a pencil and a pen and a paper or something? How many devotees don't have a pen or a pencil to write? You all have? Okay, there. You. Pencil? Anybody wants pencil? Just one. Just write one. I'll explain what that is. Just write one. Okay. We need to move fast. So turn the page. And now, if you want to identify some of the addictions or anarthas or attachments that you have, and you're not going to be sharing this with your group. Raja, you can be here, but you have to be a little quiet, okay? Thank you. Just turn the page and write, and you're not going to be sharing this with anyone, so you can be as honest as you want to be. I won't embarrass you. No, you can write as many as they fit in the paper. You have just 2 minutes to do that. Goloka, distribute this. Okay, just let them write. Wait.
next slide. Can join. Just join our group. Hold on. Write one on one side, and in the back you write whatever addiction or anatta that you have that you want to work on.
Sure.
And it's for yourself. You know, you don't have to share with others. You can join a group there. You have a paper. How many more minutes do you want? Are you all done mostly? Okay. No, no. Just few, whatever you think. Okay. So now, so ask yourself this question. What does your addiction give you? And it's a group discussion. This is important. When you're doing your group discussion, you don't have to mention what your addiction is. But just talk about what does your addiction give you. We are not interested in sharing, oh, this is my addiction, that's my, no. But what, and then I'm going to give a sheet. It kind of gives you an idea. It's a sheet of, Goloka, you have the sheet? It's a sheet which talks about universal human needs. So generally, this is, most of our addictions, you know, if you analyze, they fall into this category, like it's fulfilling one of these needs. So if you can, Golok Prabhu, can you give to the Matujis? You don't have that many? How many did you print? Okay, can you give, each group can, the women can have. See, now I'm, no, I don't want anybody to tell. That's not important. What is important is what it gives you to understand, like, if you have an addiction, what it gives you, because it's not so important to label it and share with others. That's not important. Actually, I'm not going that path. Some people would want to may take it like that. I wanted to go that path. I'm sorry, if you like this list to take home, I'll make more copies at the end of the day and give you. There has been some printing mistake. Yes. Yes.
So you see that basically, as you've been hearing, Anartha is our these needs, so standing between us and him, because we are looking for these needs, not in Krishna.
Yes.
This list, it's not that it has to be from this list. It's just an example, okay? Just an example for you to understand. Are we ready? You need few more minutes? Ready? Not yet. You can discuss as a group. Yeah, yeah, it's a group. It's a group activity. It's not individual activity, it is group activity. One more minute. Actually, sorry, you have 5 more minutes. You have time. You have 5 more minutes. Sita, join a group.
Join a group.
How many are there? A group cannot exceed 7. 1, 2,
3, 4, 5.
Sita, join this group. Yeah. You need a chair? Hare Krishna. we are little bit behind schedule. So if each group can take 30 seconds and share what came from their group discussion. Marcel, your group is ready? 30 seconds. Mothers, 30 seconds each group gets, because I'm running a little bit behind schedule. So 30 seconds. No, you keep your hand, discuss. Each group gets 30 seconds to present their what came up in your group discussion? Marcel. Okay. Hare Krishna. I know these discussions are very interesting, but we have to move on because there are many exciting things waiting. If you get stuck here, we miss out on very, very, very important, like actually the most important part of the presentation. Okay, yeah. Try to keep the group to be like group of seven as much as you can, because beyond seven it becomes too big. Okay. We need to pause here now. Pause. Okay, Marcel.
Well, what we discussed, it's all sense gratification, and it kind of harms our physical and mental well-being in some way.
Okay. What does it give you?
It gives us pleasure for a short amount of time, but then in the long run, it makes us suffer more.
Okay. Thank you. Madhav Mangal Prabhu's group. Marcel, you need to run. You are the 30 seconds, please. Your 30 seconds start now.
Ease, joy, pleasure, acceptance, consideration, kindness.
Are the hold on, pause. Matajis, are you listening? Okay. And slow.
Oh, I got 30 seconds. Mutual recognition, respect, to be heard and seen, to be trusted, internal peace.
Good. Ashok Prabhu's group. And your 30 seconds starts now.
So what we get out of it is sometimes creative expression.
Loud.
Sometimes creative expression,
mm-hmm.
Pleasure.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes we just do it to waste time, do nothing but unproductive, killing of the time. And you know, in the long run, we find that it is going to be hazardous for us.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to provide us much value in the long run.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Prabhu. Vamsidhari Prabhu, 30 seconds.
Some of us, it gives peace of mind,
mm-hmm.
Food.
Mm-hmm.
For some, it gives attention.
Yes.
And for some, there are many things, more than 10 items.
Okay. Thank you. Shweta, your group? Okay, Sanya.
We get four primary things, all related: comfort, self-connection, acceptance, and self-worth.
Great. Mansi Ganga Mataji, your group? 30 seconds. Prabhus?
Autonomy, and then pleasure, rejuvenation, attention. No, it's all relational, most of them, and some of them are more of just like worth and to be heard. And
self-worth.
Yes, self-worth. Yeah. So
thank you. Jai. Thank you. Sumangala Mataji's group? 30 seconds.
So what we came up with that it gives us satisfaction, happiness, security, protection, strength, temporary healing, communication.
Great. Mahati Mataji's group.
I'm looking up with the pleasure,
mm-hmm.
Space from responsibility,
mm-hmm.
And autonomy, security, and giving substitution for anxiety or something
softer.
Stimulation, guilt,
mm-hmm.
beauty, intense need to share.
Mm-hmm. Great, thank you. Okay, can we go to the next slide, please? So basically, our anarthas are like the block to our path towards Krishna. So when you see that this is a road towards Krishna, but then there's this huge boulder right in the middle of the road, it's like this block between us and Krishna. And that block is actually all the points that you brought, in all these feelings, these needs, these desires. And what we are doing is we are expecting that that somebody else outside of us will address these desires or fulfill these desires. Actually, and as long as we try to do that, it will, our anarthas or our addictions will look like this huge, and they are always between us and Krishna. So if we can somehow channelize the desire and then understand that actually Krishna is the source of fulfilling all those desires. And what does that mean? That means as we go internal, we ask ourselves, where is this need for attention come from? Where does this need for the sadness come from? And where is this anger coming from? And when you address that and you work on yourself, and it's not the other person, it's you. It's always you, and it's actually affecting your relationship with Krishna. When you do that, then you realize that actually these anarthas, very easily, they diminish. Because Krishna has this ability to take away. Actually, it's not by our endeavors, we have heard this, but it's by mercy of Krishna. So what happens is, and this is the crucial point of my presentation, so please pay full attention, because this is the most critical step in our anartha nivritti. We all have experienced, I'm sure, a time in our life where situations have made us feel like we are totally overwhelmed. We feel totally helpless. And you may try different things, but still nothing happens. Actually, what actually helps, and you may be even determined, like, you know, I want to get rid of this anartha, I want to go beyond this addiction. We try for a few days and then we fail. And then we go, we go down the mental path, you know, what was the terminology that we used in our last week's seminar? Imposter syndrome. We put all these labels, I am this, I am that. So how can we stop that? It's as simple as grace. You have to have grace of Krishna. That's actually mercy. So what is most important, no matter how difficult it is, and no matter how difficult it is to chant or to have any taste, to maintain any taste in any aspect of Krishna consciousness, but somehow if you can raise your hand and call out to Krishna, my dear Krishna, please help me. Please, please, please. I can't get. That's the most crucial, critical part of our anartha nivritti. Thereon, the process is much easier to address your anartha. But you somehow have to manage to get to that point of raising your hand and calling out to Krishna, just the way. Like in Srimad Bhagavatam, who is good at Sanskrit and like loud and clear, slow voice? Prabhu, you can do? So, yeah.
This is from Gajendra's prayers in the 8th canto. Jiji Vishenaham Ihama Uyakim Andar Bahishchalate Vironya Ichhadikale Nayasya Viplas Tasyatma Loka Varanasya Moksham. I do not wish to live anymore after I am released from the attack of the crocodile.
What is the use of an elephant's body covered externally and internally by ignorance? I simply desire external liberation from the covering of ignorance. That covering is not destroyed by the influence of time.
Can you just do the English, please?
Okay. Now, fully desiring release from material life, I offer my respectful obeisances unto that Supreme Person who is the creator of the universe, who is himself the form of the universe, and who is nonetheless transcendental to this cosmic manifestation. He is the supreme knower of everything in this world, the supersoul of the universe. He is the unborn, supremely situated Lord. I offer my respectful obeisances unto him.
I would like to share a story of Mother Krishna Leela. I took her permission to share this because she was sharing with me when we were discussing about this presentation, and she was telling she was 45 and she was going through a mess in her life, a divorce. She was addicted to alcohol. She was a smoker and her health was not doing good and she was really in a mess. And she thought, oh, I need to do something about my life. So she went to school. She did her degree in psychology. That didn't help. She did different things. That didn't help. And one day she met somebody who is a Buddhist follower. And she said, what should I do? You know, I'm so stuck. And nothing, I went to school thinking that if I'll understand psychology, I'll understand what my problem is. It's not helping. I'm going here, I'm going there. Nothing is helping. And that person said, well, you need grace of God. And she said, okay, how can I get grace of God? And she said, go to the airport. And she said, what does that mean, go to the airport, you know? So you'll find somebody there. You know, the teachers, you know, they come to the airport. So she went to the airport, and that's how, like, she met devotees. And that's how her whole Krishna consciousness started. And today she is 76, and she's a very unique personality. She practices Krishna consciousness on her terms, but she's very Krishna conscious, you know. And she has, in her own way, given shelter to so many of us. It's amazing. So I felt like, you know, that could be an inspiration story, a single mom in New York coming from Argentina, you know, being addicted to so many things. And today, she's happy. She's just, and she's able to give because she has gone through that process. And most of us know who she is, so, you know, it can be an inspiration. So we can do it. I'm giving her example because she's, like, you know, she's been very open, kind enough to use her example. And if she can do it, she said, anybody can. She told me, Himangi, anybody can do it. So I thought personally, like, you know, I would like to share the story. And so now you have the second sheet I gave. Write two on that. Two, number two. One, that for the first one was one, right? Two. And I give you 5 minutes. Write a personal prayer. It should be a expression. I've given a kind of guidelines of how to write the prayer, if you want to use this. Expression of current condition. Seeking grace, not relief. Requesting a lifetime of service, relationship. So basically, it's not just, oh Krishna, take away my this anartha. It should be that, Krishna, somehow give me the strength to transcend what's causing this mental agitation. Because as long as we have this material body, we will have these anarthas, things that we don't want. So give me the strength that I can transcend these mental disturbances, and give me the strength to face them and whatever, and be patient to receive your grace. So my relationship with you can continue. My service to you and your devotees can continue in that mood. Something similar to what Jamuna Jivana presented yesterday in his presentation. And these prayers are going to be offered at the lotus feet of Sri Sri Kishore Kishori today. All your prayers will be personally offered. So please, whatever you want to really offer, ask for. Okay. Do you need a few more minutes or you're ready? Ready? Okay. No? Okay, one more minute. You can go quickly. So now that you all have offered your prayers, written down your prayers, I have a request. We are going to chant for about 7 minutes. It's not going to be one round because I have to time myself. Not even 7 minutes, maybe 5 minutes. Please try to be as attentive as you can and let your attention go to your prayer. And I'll be playing Prabhupada's japa. And when 5 minutes are done, we are going to have a fire yajna here. You know the list that you had, your anartha list, which had one? Hold that in your hand. We'll be standing around the fire yajna in a semicircle. And we will be praying to Krishna. And with Krishna and our founder Acharya Srila Prabhupada's presence, do it very mindfully. Please don't do the action like fast. For you to integrate what's happening and what happened throughout the retreat, this is the point of absorption and integrating that with your consciousness in your body. A very meditative, very slow movement. So when you're standing there, don't have conversations, be in a contemplative mood and meditate on your anarthas and, you know, offer your prayers to Krishna, and then very slowly, mindfully put your papers in the anartha, and please take this visual with you home. Krishna is capable of burning away all our anarthas. So I'm trying to create a visual for all of you. So it's very important. So please, this is going to be the more meditative part of the presentation. Let's start the japa. Goloka ready? And there is this visual.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram.
I hate to do this, I know. It's nice to chant like this, but we are running a little behind schedule. So next, what we are going to do is, Prabhu has started the yajna fire, and if we can make semicircles, but everybody cannot be together, so let's do like the first line comes forward, the first row offers their number one, they list the addictions, the anarthas that we have into the fire very meditatively and slowly, and then just move fast so the others can also do that. Yes, Shravan Prabhu. Okay, can Matajis, you can come. I'm biased, I'm a Mataji, so I have to ask Matajis to come first. Okay, number one, and please don't have personal conversations, please be in meditative mood. It's yes, and Naam Kirti, soft kirtan, please. You all can stand here. Please move fast because Maharaj is going to come down, so I have to finish by one. And make behind them you stand, so it's very clear. Make a semicircle. Make a semicircle.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
As you're doing it, please take this visual with you. Don't do it mechanically.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
the Prabhus can come forward now, slowly, very meditatively.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
If you can collect the prayers. Yeah, and if you want your prayers back, write your names. Otherwise, you want it back?
Krishna,
your prayers.
Krishna,
you can collect this way.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna,
personal conversations. You're still part of the seminar. Continue playing the harmonium. Please don't leave the room. We're still not done with our session with the prayers. It's not yet done. As soon as the aarti is over, we are coming and collecting your prayers, which you have written in paper too. It will be personally offered at the lotus feet of Kishore Kishori, and that will be your moment. Assume that you're really Krishna, you're making an offering to Krishna personally. And Srimati Radharani is personally accepting your prayer and giving it to Krishna and making our case. So it is a very, please take this also, like, you know, slow. Let it integrate with your body. Don't do it fast. Please don't have personal conversations and get distracted with Rajalila. I know she's very cute, but stay focused here, okay? And Namkiti, just continue. You want to put your paper? It's there. Thank you. And you can all softly chant till Prabhu goes. Very soft Ketan.
Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
everyone can now slowly move towards the altar. You can turn if you want to face the deity.
Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Yeah, to continue with the kirtan. It's written.
Hare Krishna.
You want to stand? You want to stand? You can stand
too. Hare Hare.
Mother to all of us. Please accept all our prayers and offer to our dear Kishore. My dear Kishore, we are not qualified to be serving you, but you have been so merciful that you are letting us marry some of our lotus feet. Please keep us at your lotus feet. Sorry to interrupt your meditation. We have last 5 minutes. If somebody wants to share or how you have integrated this whole experience so you can take it home, how it is, whatever you want to share, if somebody wants to. If people are shy, you can, if you want to continue doing this, I'm fine. You want to continue doing this? Seems like it. You can keep doing the kirtan. I don't think they want. Sorry. Continue praying.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
I'm sorry to interrupt. Ravika Prabhu is here, so we have to go to the next program. Thank you all. Hare Krishna.
Yeah.